မင်္ဂလာပါခင်ဗျာဧပြီလ26ရက်နေ့ဟာကမ္ဘာလုပ်ငန်းငွေလုံခြုံရေးစစ်ချမှုနဲ့ကျန်းမာရေးဆိုင်ရာနေ့တနေ့ဖြစ်ပါတယ်ခင်ဗျအဲ့တော့ကျွန်တော်တို့ဒီလုပ်ငန်းငွေလုံခြုံရေးစစ်ချမှုနဲ့ကျန်းမာရေးဆိုင်ရာခြေအနေတွေကိုကျွန်တော်မြေစီမ exclusive interview စီစဉ်ကနေပြီးတော့မြန်မာနိုင်ငံဆိုင်ရာဒိမ့်မတ်တမ်မတ်ချင်းနဲ့ဆွေးနွေးမေးမြန်းသွားမှာဖြစ်ပါတယ်တမ်မတ်ချင်းကတော့မစ္စတာဂျွန်နယ်ဆင်ဖြစ်ပါတယ်ခင်ဗျတမ်မတ်ချင်းကနေပြီးတော့မာဒီလုံငန်းငွေလုံခြုံရေးစစ်ချမှုရှိတယ်ဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ကောင်းကျိုးရလဒ်တွေကပါတယ်ဖြစ်လာမလဲလုပ်ငန်းငွေလုံခြုံရေးစစ်ချမှုမရှိတဲ့ လုပ်ငန်းငွေတစ်ခုအားဆိုလို့ရှိရင်အဲဆိုးကျိုးတွေပါတယ်ဖြစ်လာမလဲဆိုတာကိုဒီကနေ့မြေစီမ exclusive interview စီစဉ်ကနေဆွေးနွေးသွားမှာဖြစ်ပါတယ်ခင်ဗျာ
Then thanks for coming to here for interview. Then let me ask the first question. Why it is important for Myanmar to scale up in relation to occupation safety and health?
Well, first of all, I would like to thank you for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to talk about a very important issue that is being more and more important as Myanmar is progressing as an open market economy. I think what is important here to say that it's good for all parties involved. It's good for the workers if you can improve, of course, their rights and their working environments. But it's also good for the companies because they'll get healthier workers and they will also get an opportunity of exporting to some countries in Europe and the US where they normally would not be able to export to. And lastly, it's also good for the Myanmar economy. So it is a win-win situation if you can do things for all parties involved.
So the second question, why is it important for EU that Myanmar develop in relationship to occupational safety and health?
I think, as you know, EU today is the third biggest market for export from Myanmar. And especially within the garment industry, the export has increased a lot. If you look at EU today, you will see that the consumers increasingly in the EU are asking for purer goods where they buy it, but they're also asking into the working conditions in the places where the things that they buy are produced. Mm-hmm. So if Myanmar can do something to improve the worker condition and the health facilities at companies, of course, it will be very important for the consumers in these countries, and they are actually willing to pay more for it.
Yeah, thank you. Third question: would it not be easier for everyone, the companies, employees, employers, if there any is there were no rule concerning occupational safety and health?
No, I don't think so. No, it would be bad for everyone, because as I said before, the consumers in Europe would not like to buy. Goods from countries where the working conditions are not good. There's an increasing awareness of that in Europe, but also in the US and in many other parts of the world. Secondly, I think, of course, it is our duty also to ensure that the workers get good working conditions and they get full rights to improve their working conditions where they are. And thirdly, I think if Myanmar wants to increase the productivity within many sectors, and if they want to, the country as such wants to increase the competitiveness of the economy, it will be necessary. Myanmar is opening up to the world, has been opening up to the world, and will, in that process, which is going to be a long process because you're coming from a closed society, where you're opening it up now for new markets, where the consumer interests are different from the market that you have traditionally worked with. So you will have to try to understand these markets, you will have to understand, try to understand the consumer's concerns. And in that sense, I think the competitiveness of Myanmar also depends on whether you can do something to improve the situation for the workers in the country that you are working with. And I think in that sense, the EU, for instance, since 2013 through the Smart Program, has been working on ensuring that the companies are increasingly in compliance with the general rules for good labor environment. Yes, I think it's important to know that since 2014, the EU, the US, Japan, the ILO and Denmark has jointly been working with the government and been working with the employers, has also been working with the workers' unions on improving the general environment for workers here. But that has also been part of, you could say, a reform of the labor market as such, because you cannot see what is happening within this area without going into the whole labor market. So you have to have a comprehensive look at it. And in that sense, I think the progress that we have seen through this funding and through this work is gradually moving forward. Yeah. But it, of course, takes a long time when you come from a situation where Myanmar were before.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. It is expensive for the companies and comply rule about occupational safety and health. How can it be an advance for the companies?
Yeah, I mean, it could look like it's not an advance, yeah. But I mean, in the long run, it's going to be an advance if they invest in these things, because it is something that people in the markets where Myanmar is exporting to are concerned about. The consumers are concerned about it.
Yeah.
So if you want to ensure that you are able to export to these markets in the future, it will not only be about quality, but it will also be about where these products are being produced. So you will have an increasing demand. We see an increasing demand in our countries and in the US and Australia and others, that consumers want to know where these products are being produced on and under which circumstances. Mm-hmm. I think, as you know, there was a big incident in Bangladesh some years ago within the garment industry, and that has put a lot of focus on corporate social responsibility. And in that sense, many of the Danish and European companies who are working in Myanmar are really concerned about these issues, and because they know that back home their consumers are interested, they want to know that the working conditions are good at the different companies where we are getting the product from. And I mean, many of the products that goes to Europe today are not necessarily coming from European companies. That's many of them within the garment industry. There's Chinese companies who are not maybe at that level in the CSR, on the CSR scale that is necessary to produce into the European market.
Yeah, thank you. For Myanmar, it seemed to be difficult to raise awareness about occupational safety and health. How can its process to be boosted?
It's going to be a long endeavor. It's going to be a long journey, I think, because you have to change a culture where this has not been important. Mm-hmm. And but as you are opening up as a market to a new international market, you'll have to change that mentality. And I mean, I think the companies have to see that it is actually worth investing in better improvement. It provides healthier workers, which can also lead to increased productivity. Mm-hmm. But it also ensures a better competitiveness in the future, because they will have to compete in an international market where the standards are set by the consumers in these countries that they're exporting to. But it's going to take a long time, and it will need a lot of cultural change over time. And I think the EU and Denmark and other countries, member states, are really keen to support Myanmar in this area through different projects and initiative and technical assistance.
Yeah. What is the projects now do you have here in Myanmar?
The Danish Ministry of Foreign Affairs have a project where we are supporting the Minister of Labour with introducing people who made checks at the companies to ensure that the working conditions are in order. We are actually training inspectors who can go out and ensure that the training, that the working conditions are improved at mm-hmm. different companies. And we have an advisor at the embassy who's working on these things. And as I said before, within the garment industry, the EU is supporting the SMART program, which is trying to ensure that compliance are being met according to labor standards and so on in different projects.
Yeah, I would like to ask more about SMART program. Can you please explain more that?
It's a project which has been ongoing since 2013, and the thing is that it's focusing on trying to tell the advantages to the companies here of trying to comply with the rules and regulation and improvements of working standards and procedures for workers in the companies. As part of the Danish support, we are actually also supporting what we call the social dialogue, or the dialogue between the unions and the employers and the government on different issues. We have a specific setup in Denmark mm-hmm. where we try to settle issues related to worker conditions in between the three parties. Oh. So we're also trying to work on this here.
Thank you so much. How was Myanmar development in the occupational safety and health over the last years, over the couple of years?
I think if you look back at where Myanmar came from and where Myanmar is today, quite a number of things has happened, and I'm very happy also that the occupational safety and health law was passed by Parliament in March this year. This is a very important step towards trying to put a lot more focus on the issues, mm-hmm. and as we talked about before, also to change the culture mm-hmm. of not having concerned much about that before. So I think a lot of things are happening here in Myanmar on the issues, and we have had both the EU and also Denmark, we have had a very good relationship and cooperation with the ministry mm-hmm. on this, and also with the unions. And I think, so in that sense, I think Myanmar is moving forward, but there's a long way to go. And I think sometimes we also have to recall our own history yeah. in that sense, because we are where we are today after many, many years, even decades. So this is going to take a long time, but as we look back over the last 8-10 years here in Myanmar, mm-hmm. things are progressing in the right direction. Not fast, but it's the direction is getting better and better. I'm not talking only about the law, I'm also talking about the changes to the labor market as such mm-hmm. and other labor laws which mm-hmm. are in progress. And I hope that also these laws, once they are being passed by the parliament, will live up to international regulations mm-hmm. and standards, because that will be a huge step forward for the Myanmar economy, both in Europe and the US and Australia and others. Yeah.
So you said that Myanmar is going to the right way. So what would you like to message to the employer and to the government sector, to the government members?
I think it's important to take the issue on tripartite discussions important, and ensure a dialogue, that it is a dialogue between mm-hmm. all parties. Mm-hmm. It's not only one with another, or you cannot just go ahead with these reforms and make progress if you don't have a dialogue with the other parties. Yeah. It's very, very important that the labor market consists of basically three, and you have to have all three parties involved in a dialogue all mm-hmm. the way along to ensure that there's a compromise about where you're going and how you're going to do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you. What is positive about the deployment or raising awareness about occupational safety and health in Myanmar?
I think it's very important to people to understand that it's a right for workers to have better working conditions. Yeah. And I think that has taken some time, especially for many companies, to understand that it's not only about competitiveness, but it's also a right that the workers are getting better competitiveness, they're getting better conditions at their workplace. And it is also, by the end of the day, leading to an improved productivity, because we see that from our experiences in Europe, in the EU, that if you improve the working conditions, you also, in many cases, raises the productivity, which by the end of the day is a benefit for the companies. And so I think it's a right, but it's also something which can lead to better benefit for all parties.
Yeah. Thank you. What is the most important in raising occupational safety and health at a company's level?
I think the most important is that there is a dialogue between the workers and the companies on how to do these things, because of course some of the companies cannot invest overnight in long-term improvements for workers. So, but initiating a dialogue which was not there before, yeah, it's very, very important. And I mean, this is not easy, because many of the companies that we're talking about are not necessarily Myanmar companies or European companies. They're also from other countries and other cultures. So it's not easy. But with the new law, where you also introduce the possibility of setting up committees at companies where the workers and the employers, they can talk together, I think, if that is being implemented, that could be very important for the future development of the labor conditions here.
Yeah, you have a smart program and other same programs here in Myanmar. When you do these projects, what is the difficulty on doing that?
I think it's very difficult when you come from a situation 8-10 years ago where you had no consciousness about these problems. Mm-hmm. There was no one discussing worker condition, working conditions, and you were not an open economy. You were not open to the world. You were not. You didn't have the perspective of what good working relations could actually mean for your economy. So moving from there and to a situation where you have to compete in an international setting, market, where your products have to be scrutinized, whether they are coming from companies which are actually living up to general human rights standards, you could say that ILO standards, it's a huge task and it takes a long time.
Yeah.
And as I said before, you have many cultures of companies also here, which makes it even more difficult. But I think if you look at the broader perspective over the last 8 years, Myanmar are advancing at a reasonable pace. And what I feel is important is that we feel the willingness on part of the government to progress in this area, and also the unions are interested in progressing in this area, and the employer. So there is an environment for moving forward, but it's going to take a long time. And as I said before, our experience is that this has taken decades in Europe. It has taken decades in the US or other countries. Yeah. So this is nothing which is happening overnight. But the first steps, path have been taken, and I think that's very important. And that's why I think the introduction of the law has been a very important step forward in this area.
Yeah, exactly. What barrier do you see in developing and occupational safety and culture in Myanmar?
No, it is very difficult, and it takes a long time. I mean, you have to overcome a situation where people are not dealing with these things, and you have to understand the companies have to understand the advantages of doing these things, and also, I mean, the culture of talking together, the culture of dialogue, the culture of creating confidence between the workers and the employers was not here before in that sense. So I mean, you have to move from such a situation to a situation where you have to, as part of the new law, also to initiate a dialogue on the working in the companies. And that will take a long time. it's easy to make a law, and I mean the next step is the most important, that's implementation of the law. Yeah. And that's where you can actually see whether what have been done over the last couple of years is actually going to be effective. But it'll take time.
Yeah, thank you. What barrier do you see for the future for Myanmar in terms of occupational safety and health?
I think there are many. We were talking about the culture that you are not used to work on these issues at the companies. You are also dealing with a mixed group of international companies being present here, which doesn't necessarily have or share the same ideas or values about everything. So that is a barrier. That's also something that will have to be overcome. I mean, the law is very important in that sense because it sets out a general regulations for all companies, notwithstanding which country they're from. But I mean, the path forward is dialogue. It's dialogue between the employers and the workers. It's dialogue between the employers and the government, and between the workers and the government. I think that's where you find the progress in the future. And if you can reach such a dialogue, then I'm very optimistic about the future of developing this area in the future.
Thank you. The last question. Can you please message to the people or people to Myanmar the worry for safety and health? Short message, please. Just message. What would you like to tell to them?
Yeah, I would say that first of all, it's a right for the workers to have good working conditions. That's crucial. That's essential. That's part of their rights as human beings. Secondly, it's good for Myanmar. It's good for the economy of Myanmar if you can increase the productivity, if the companies can increase the productivity through having better working conditions at the company's level. So I think it's a good, it's a win-win situation for both the companies, the Myanmar economy and the workers, if you go along this road. So it's a very important step forward, and it's very important as Myanmar is opening up its market to the modern world. Maybe just mention the reason why we're doing is actually that we have the day on the 28th, the World Day on Occupational Safety and Health. So I think that's a good opportunity, and I could round up with a few words about that.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else would you like to add?
No, I think first of all, again, I would thank you for giving me this opportunity on behalf of the EU countries to commemorate this day. This is the World Day where we are celebrating the occupational health and occupational safety and health. So it's a good opportunity to talk about what has happened here in Myanmar. I think a lot of things are on the right track, and there's still a lot of issues to be done in relation to the whole labor market here. And I know laws are upcoming, and as I said, I think it's very important that they are up to the standards of the international organizations. But again, I think you've gone far way on in very short time, and this is going to take a long time, and I wish you all the best and good luck in the future. So thank you very much.
Thank you so much.